to my channel. I hope you're having a great day. Today, this video is about how to walk in a feminine way, how to move yourself in a feminine and elegant way, like a true lady, ladylike behavior and all that. So if you want to know more, keep watching. But first, just wanted to let you know that if you want to see more of this kind of video, don't forget to subscribe down below. And also don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, which is LisaHardstyle. So to move in a feminine way and in an elegant way, I always say that the most important is your posture. So for example, your posture right now should be really straight. It shouldn't be like a robot, like without moving, but you should be straight. Your shoulder shouldn't be like this. It should be like this. If you have a doubt, do this. You know, put your shoulders back like this. And if you have a doubt, it's really important that your shoulders should be straight up. Your chin also should be up, but not too up, because you don't want to appear arrogant. But like level on the middle, like this, and it's just perfect. So I see that so many times. You have so many people that have their shoulder like this because it's more comfortable, of course. But it's so much better to have your shoulder like this. It's so much also better for your back. Your back will say thank you. So then you have the posture, you have the shoulder, you have the chin that is up, not down. Don't look on the floor. Don't look on the floor. I see that so many times. So many times people just look on the floor when they're walking. And then you have this. It's not elegant, it's not beautiful, it's not feminine, it's not giving you any justice. So it's not emphasizing your beauty. If you look down, you look like you want to hide yourself. Look at people in the eyes. You know, look at people in the eyes, have your chest up, everything is on point. Also, let's talk about something else. Let's talk about your arms, because most people don't know where they should put their arms. And so I had a very, very good teacher when I was in college, and she was teaching how to just have a good presentation on how to walk naturally. And naturally your arms are just moving. You're not a robot and you don't walk like this. So your arms are just moving when you walk. And so it's natural, it's not too much. Don't do this. Moving naturally, you know? Don't try to force it. I have a bag all the time on my right arm, and so one of my arm is not used to moving. So sometimes I just notice that one of my arm is like straight and the other one is moving. So I try to force myself to have both of them moving, but just naturally. So another tip is to have one foot in front of the other. It's really something useful. You just imagine that you follow a line on the floor and you have one foot in front of the other. Not too much like you're gonna do something ridiculous. No, like really natural. It's just gonna emphasize the way of your hips moving. So let me show you. Shoulder up, chin up. You prepare, your arms are going to move, and then do you see how it emphasizes the hips really nicely, but not too much? Your hips should move, but not too harshly, not too much. Let's go. Do you see it's really a ladylike move, a ladylike walk? Most people nowadays, they walk like this. So they walk like this. And so it's not, absolutely not feminine to walk like this. Because you open your legs like this, it's not feminine, it's kind of masculine, kind of how the men are walking actually. So really need to walk like you're a lady, like you're floating. You're floating, you're floating, you're floating, you're floating, you're floating. You are floating. You're not. So shoulder up, chin up, your arms ready, and then you go. You see? And you don't have to be too harsh on your walk. Just floating naturally and just not be. No, you're lady. You're ready to go. And you see how my hips are just moving naturally without exaggerating, without being too much, without being like, because most people think that for being feminine, you have to do this. No. No. No, no, no. You're not on the catwalk, just on the street. Natural. It's really beautiful, really feminine, because the hips are just something really feminine, because men don't have hips. Men don't have this, and if you emphasize it through your walk, you just notice that when you put one foot in front of the other, your hips are just gonna emphasize immediately, naturally. You don't have to exaggerate it. You can try it on at home and see, put your hands on your hips, and you just notice that your hips are just gonna go up naturally. So now that you know actually a little bit about the basics on how to walk in a feminine way and a classy way, this is just practicing. Just practice. You can just practice at home, you can just practice outside, you know, and you just also can practice on how to walk with heels. Because if you don't know how to walk with heels, you have to learn it. You really have to learn it. Don't walk with heels if you don't know how to walk with heels. And so if you prefer not to wear heels, that's totally fine. Just wear flats and you can still walk like this in a very feminine way. I think heels just adds more femininity. It's just emphasizing your body, your curves and everything, because it's just up. Your curves are going to naturally come out. We just want to be fine and elegant in our everyday life, so we don't need to have heels crazy high, you know? So you're going to need to be very graceful when you walk. You need to be like you're floating, almost like you don't make any noise. I know it's hard, like you don't want to be like this. You don't want to be this. You hear, it's very harsh. It's very like boom, boom, boom. I'm just walking into the room really harshly. No, just want to floating. Floating like a lady. Let me show you. Floating naturally like a lady. You almost don't hear my steps. So that's how you do it. And that's really like walking into a cloud. When you're moving your body, trying to be more graceful and slowly. Slowly. You don't have to move like this. Yeah, 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 yeah. No. Be more gentle. Have like, you know, this kind of exercise for the hands are really interesting. It's exercising of belly dance, actually. It's belly dance. So belly dance, I suggest you do it. It's really amazing for approaching more femininity, for being more feminine. I'm just obsessed with it. I love belly dance, and I grew up seeing my mother dancing belly dance, so I really know how to do it. If you want like a little lesson of belly dancing, let me know in the comments below. That could be fun. I suggest to have those kind of exercising, you know, trying to put your hands like this. It's just really nice to just practice at home, you know, in front of a movie. You just do this. Maybe people were gonna make fun of you, but you don't care. Just do this, and then when you're going to talk to the people outside, she's gonna have this natural way of moving your hand that is very, very feminine and very soft, very elegant. You know, when you know how to move your hand in a feminine way, that's exactly what we do in belly dance. You're more soft and delicate in your movement. Also, I want to talk about the way of standing like a proper lady. So standing like a proper lady, I just noticed that we have different way of standing. The way that is the most ladylike is probably this way, and probably having your hands like this. You just want to avoid to have your legs apart from each other. A lady is always having her legs close to each other. A lady always has her legs next to each other to just have be more proper, you know, be more modest. You don't want to show anyone anything. So a lady really have always this kind of posture, always like the posture that is legs next to each other. That's why we also have this posture when we sit down. It's always legs next to each other. Never open your legs, even if you have trousers like pants or anything. Don't open your legs. It's really not a ladylike thing to do. Like this is really a great way to stand like a proper lady. I really like this kind of stand. with the hands like this. It's really, really elegant, really proper. Also, you can just have your hands like this, you know, like, and can you see that my hands are just graceful, really gracefully, like this? And then you can also, oh yes, oh, when you're talking, you can move your hand again in a very graceful way. Also, I want to talk about something else, which is your smile. Your smile is very feminine. Smiling when you walk, just not smiling, like completely smiling, but just a little tiny bit. You know, like when you walk, you enter a room, and even if you have like someone to seduce or something like this, walking in a very feminine way and have a little smile on your face, it's really making the people feel comfortable around you, which is the point of a lady. And also when you're talking to the people, when you're standing, when you just have a conversation, try to have a smile on your face. That's really, really gonna change everything. And also maybe when you look at people when you're walking, you have a nice look, you know, how they do it in the movies. You have the big smile and the big, yeah, oh yes, yes, haha, I'm laughing with your friends. And if you want to seduce, it's kind of softer way of smiling and kind of softer way of looking at the other person. Angelina Jolie is really good example on how to look at people in the eyes and seductive look, you know, it's really powerful. In American Top Model, Tyra Banks talked about this, the smiles. See, it's like smiling with your eyes. If you want to seduce, you're not gonna smile like, hey, hello. No, you're gonna feel like a fool. So you need to have a smile. Like a seducing look with a little smile on your face. Practice a little bit, you can do some research about it. It's really something powerful. It's really something that you have to practice. You have to know how to do it. So also another thing that I want to talk about is take your time. Take your time. Take your time to walk properly. A lady is always taking her time to have her step, nice step. Because if you have, especially if you have heels, you don't want to fall down on the floor like no. So if you're a lady, you want to have nice posture, nice smile, and also taking your time to walk properly. And if someone is too fast for you, they have to wait for you. You have to wait for the lady to arrive, my lady. when you turn around, like when you turn on the left, when you turn on the right. So I saw that with Miss Universe. Is how to properly walk and how to properly turn. If you turn in a way that is like this, if you turn with your legs apart like this, it's not really gonna appear elegant. But instead of that, you can just have your toe open and just turning in a way that is more ladylike, which is putting the opposite leg first. When you're going to turn right, you take the left leg to the right. You put your feet like this, and then you put the leg on the right. You see how it's more elegant to just turn like this? And if you want to turn on the other side, you just turn like this. Try to practice as much as possible to even turn like this. You know, when I'm doing my locus, I always try to have some certain pose and all that. So I'm just posing like an actual model, but you're not gonna do this, of course, in real life. You're not gonna be like, hello, I turn, hello. No, this is kind of extreme. Moving in a more feminine way, gracious, softer, and I really think that belly dancing is really something useful if you want to be more graceful. So that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. I hope it was useful for you. And if you have any question, you can leave it in the comments below. Also, don't forget to subscribe down below for lots more feminine and elegant video. Also, don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, which is LisaHartStyle. And until next time, I'm giving you a lot of kisses. Mwah. Goodbye.